One great feature of Git is that you have the ability to experiment or make changes without affecting your project. In order to do this, you need to learn some extra Git commands that'll help you modify your workflow. In this video, you'll learn how to divert your experimentation or new changes away from your primary saved work using branches. Once you have an understanding of branches, you can then take your changes and incorporate them into your primary saved work. Let's go ahead and get started. When you make your first commit in a repository, you're given a branch. Branches are simply named bookmarks for commits, or more precisely, branches are pointers. Every time you've made a commit, the named branch points to the last commit you made to designate that this commit and the commits that came before it are labeled under the name of this branch. Let's go ahead and make our way over to the command line to meet our first branch. I'm going to make a project directory again for campus advisor list. So make dir campus advisor list. I want to use git init to create a repository. Now I'm going to create an empty readme.md file. Now I want to move the readme from my working directory to the staging area by adding it. Then I'm going to commit with a new message, add readme.md. Now let's discover our first default branch given to us by typing a git command that reveals all the branches we have, which is branch. Git branch, and then we'll see that we have one branch named master. Master is just a naming convention, so really it could be anything. But by default, Git calls this branch master. The asterisk next to the master indicates that we are currently on that branch. So any future commits that we make at this point will be adding those commits under the name master branch, unless we tell Git otherwise. More on that later. As I mentioned, branches are pointers, a kind of label to a specific item. In this case, they point to the most recent commit. There's another pointer as well called head, which helps Git know what branch and commit you're currently on. Head usually points to the most recent commit. So if we wanted to actually see which commit head is pointing at, we can use the command show ref followed by the flag dash dash head. Now if we run git log, you'll notice that head is pointing at the most recent commit. For now, we can ignore any reference that appears below head. Before we move forward, I want to first visualize what a branch looks like using a tool which is at git-school.github.io/visualizing-git. This tool is incredibly helpful to visualize how Git works. While we're using this visualizer, we'll be skipping the git add command and adding messages to our commit. So don't be shocked by the fact that we're no longer using those commands. So this is just a tool to visualize branching, so those commands are removed for brevity. So here we are with our first commit, which has the master branch and head pointers on this commit. If I continue to add commits, you'll notice how the master branch and the head pointers move to the most recent commit. Now let's say I'm interested in doing some experimentation or I want to create a new feature for my code. At this point, I can use the git command branch followed by the name I want for my branch in order to diverge from the master branch. Let's go ahead and see what happens here. So notice that I have now added a new branch pointer, pointing directly at the most recent commit. It is on the most recent commit because the branch I created, with the name of new feature, has a reference to every commit that master has up to this point. So a reference to both the first and second commit can be found in the master branch and the new feature branch as well. Let's add another commit and see what happens. Notice that this commit has both the master branch and head pointers, but not the new feature branch. We have added a new commit to master and not the new feature branch. You may be thinking at this point, so how do I switch branches so I can add commits to the other branch? We can use a new git command, which is checkout. Git checkout followed by the name of the branch will allow you to switch branches. So in this case, I'll go and do that. Notice that the head pointer has moved to the new feature branch. This tells Git that I am now on the feature branch, and any new commits that I make to the new feature branch will point to it. Let's try it. So git commit. Notice that the new commit is under the new feature branch and the head pointer is still moving along with the new feature branch. You might be thinking at this point, why would I want to do this? Why would I want to create another branch? Well, in reality, branching is the recommended workflow when using Git. This is because you don't want to make changes to your master branch directly. If for some reason, if you break your code or make a change that you don't like, you have the safety net of making changes on a branch where you can easily check out and go back to master. For instance, if my new feature doesn't work, I can go back to master by checking out into it with git checkout master, and guess what? No harm done. The code will not be introduced into my code base. It is also helpful to note that you can delete branches you're not using with the command git branch dash d followed by the name of your branch. Notice that git will keep a copy of that commit you made under the new feature branch if you need to recover it. But note, it won't be there forever. Let's go ahead and step away from this visualizer and let's try to put what we learned into practice on the command line. First, let's create a new branch called add readme instructions for our new campus advisor list project. Git branch add readme instructions to make our new branch. Now, in order to make changes or commits to that branch, I need to check out of master. And from there, I can go into my add readme instructions branch. So git checkout add readme instructions. Now that I am here, let me open up my readme.md file and add my instructions. I'll put the instructions, campus advisors should open campus advisor list.txt and add their name and the school they teach at. Now let's move this from the working directory to the staging area with git add readme.md, and then move it to our repository with git commit with a message add instructions to readme.md. If we type in git log, you'll notice that our new commit is present and our previous commit is also there for master, which we expect. If we check out into master and then check our logs, what do you expect to see? Notice that we only have our first commit. The second commit only exists on the add readme instructions branch. I feel comfortable with the changes I made on the add readme instructions branch, so I want to incorporate these changes into the master branch. This can be done with the git command merge, followed by the name of the branch we want to incorporate into master. In this situation, I will do git merge add readme instructions, and I will get feedback here to tell me the merge was successful with the file changed and the number of line insertions. If I check my logs now, I have both commits on master. It's good practice to delete the branch you're no longer using. So to do that, again, we'll type in git branch dash d add readme instructions. To ensure that the branch is gone, we can type git branch and notice that the branch add readme instructions is no longer listed. Let's visually show what we accomplished using the visualizer tool. First, we did our initial readme commit. We then created another branch called add readme instructions. We checked out of the master branch to add readme instructions. We committed our instructions, checked out back into master, and merge the changes from add readme instructions into master. This is what our workflow looks like. Using the branching workflow when you add new features is highly recommended. It's an additional way to protect your master branch from mistakes, and it's also a great way to experiment. I highly recommend using this workflow with your students. We'll come back to merging later in this course, so it will be useful to keep this lesson in mind for reference.